All right, B. Who are you and what's your game? Well, if it isn't my dear old chum, Mr. Disraeli. Now, Prime Minister, which of your friends is about to stab you in the back? Now, Prime Minister, which of your friends is about to stab you in the back?
The Corrupt Practices Bill is a vital step in reforming our government. If the majority party is allowed to dictate the results of contested elections, we can scarcely call ourselves free.
If we yield up our rights bit by bit to the courts, we can scarcely call ourselves free.
This is so like you, Gladstone. You would rather throw your body upon the gears of progress than surrender one iota of power.
By God, Disraeli, you are a fool! I'll not stand idly by and watch you drag parliamentary privilege through the muck.
No, certainly not. You'd rather return us to the yoke of tyranny?
Some mothers do.
Perhaps while we're at it, Mr. Gladstone, we could repeal Magna Carta and return the crown to the bloody Stuarts!
How dare you, sir? Merely because I do not wish to see government placed in the hands of judges, you would make these slanderous accusations? I'll not stand for it!
Then I shall obviate the requirement. Good evening, sir.
I presume. Pleasure to meet you. B.
B. My name's Herbert!
And why are you following the Prime Minister?
It's just the job, sir! Some old bloke paid me to...
Smug bastard.
Oh,
bloody hell! Where'd you come from?
Well, I was born in Crawley, but that's by the by. Who are you working for?
I never got his name. Old chap, big moustache, wore some kind of uniform. Who's ours, maybe?
What's his game?
Please, you'll kill me.
And a three-story drop will shatter your legs and send you to the workhouse. Difference is, you can run from him.
Tomorrow! Oh, my lads are going to attack the Prime Minister's carriage on the way to Parliament.
Perfect. So much for the house call. I have to find a way into that carriage.
Meaning of this? Who the devil are you?
Prime Minister, I'm your new bodyguard, Jacob Fry.
I wasn't informed of any new bodyguard. Who's your commanding officer?
Let the boy speak, Dizzy.
Madam, apologies. But we've learned of a threat on your life. and the Met thought it best to move quickly.
Threat? What sort of threat?
That sort. If you excuse me a moment.
Where'd they come from?
So fast, Your Excellency.
Keeping with this distinct lack of
character. Hold on, girl.
Show yourself, Gladstone! Show yourself, you feckless mucksnipe!
Well, he's hardly going to be in the van with a cudgel, is he?
For this.
Thank you. What do you intend to do about Gladstone, young man?
I assure you, madam, Gladstone is innocent in this.
But he tried to kill my husband.
Well, we'll look into Gladstone. Perhaps you can help me with another inquiry, madam. A gentleman with ties to Parliament, older, wears cavalry uniforms and has a large mustache.
You seem like a rough and ready sort of fellow, Mr. Fry.
Well, yes, I am, actually.
And are you familiar with the poorer districts of our city?
Roughly.
Wonderful. As it happens, I've been eager to tour the Devil's Acre. If you were to escort me, I'd be happy to assist you in your inquiry.
That strikes me as a dangerous idea.
Then it's settled. Come back here to Downing Street tomorrow night, 8 o'clock sharp. Good day, Mr. Fry.
But I...
Good day, Mr. Fry!
Madam?
Mr. Fry.
Ready to take the air? Devil's Acre should just be coming alive.
I'm afraid I must cancel our engagement. The lawn is crawling with scandal-hunting journalists, and I simply cannot be seen in the company of someone so...
I'll see them off.
You follow along when it's clear.
Yes, yes. Be gentle, won't you? The press are notoriously touchy about any violence to their person.
Ha ha ha. I'll barely ruffle a hair on their heads.
Shh, Desmond.
Oh, come on. My mother won't be home for hours.
That's yours, if you can get those chaps over there to follow me.
Right you are, sir.
Help! Someone! Something bad's happened!
Blimey! Look! Esquire Bancroft!
Best lead them astray before they tear me to shreds.
Mr. Bancroft! Mr. Bancroft! What's coming up next for the Prince of Wales?
Young man. Dizzy ought to keep you on to deal with the liberals.
There, in the cart, is the Prime Minister's wife.
Easy now.
I really must not be seen here, Mr. Fry.
Yeah. Easy does it.
Easy, girl. Easy.
What a rough place. Give me your arm, Mr. Fry. Let us see what the Devil's Acre has to offer.
Is your dog quite all right?
Oh, Desmond's fine. He's just not overfond of strangers. Or cats.
Surprises me anymore.
Something seems a little off about it.
That's not right there, you little thief. Something don't feel right about this.
Do you know this gentleman is a... Oh, what was it? Yes, a costermonger, of all things. Remarkable how the working classes occupy themselves, isn't it?
Very industrious, I'm sure. Shall we go?
I saw a murder. My heart's going 9/10
to the dozen. I'm so sorry. I have no earthly idea what you're talking about.
Mrs. Disraeli. Yes, they seem to be,
I've been married twice, Mr. Fry. I'm fully aware of what they're doing. God bless them.
What's he tucked away like?
What's he doing here?
Is that man selling?
Best not to ask.
Why? Is it something dreadful? Is it rat?
I don't mean to be indelicate, given the present company, but another name for it is Bow Wow Mutton. Here we are, the old one-ton...
So this is a pint, is it? Remarkable.
Nice doggy.
Mm.
It's murder! Help!
Shut up, dog!
Good boy, Desmond. Hand over the mutt.
You'll change your tune when me and my friends find you.
Now then, Desmond, to get you back to your mistress, whom I've just left entirely unattended in one of London's most dangerous pubs.
Well, if you never told your father how you felt about him, how was he supposed to know?
I never thought of it that way. I suppose deep down we all just want to be loved.
Just so. Here, have a sweetie. Oh, Desmond and Mr. Fry, I'd like you to meet... Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't catch your name.
John the Tosser.
Charmed. I think we better get you home.
Right you are, Mr. Fry. Come along, Desmond.
Well, well, well. If it isn't the dog walker.
Now, let's not do something we'll regret.
Steady on.
Well, let's go. I must thank you for a most energetic and enlightening evening, Mr. Fry.
No, thank you, madam. Perhaps now you might tell me about the man in the Hussar's uniform.
Quite right. Lord Cardigan is the gentleman you seek. Tiresome. Always blathering on about his military adventures.
Do you know where I might find him for a private conversation?
I do indeed. He's in town now, as it happens. Campaigning against the corrupt practices. Perhaps you could catch him in the Palace of Westminster.
Who's a good horse?
Do be careful. The government could ill afford another scandal.
I assure you, I'll be very discreet. Steady on. Your stop, madam.
My stop. How delightful. Thank you. Thank you for a splendid evening, Mr. Fry. I shall be sure to speak highly of you to Dizzy. Oh, yes.
Doing fine, girl.
Money is counterfeit. I'm an honest woman.
Oh,
has happened?
Your brother.
What's he done this time?
The newspapers are all over Tupini's murder, and if that weren't enough, someone has stolen the currency printing plates. Was that also Jacob's doing?
I doubt it.
Now, no one trusts the bank or England's currency. There will be inflation, riots, manufacturing will jump to America for the cheap labor. In short, Britain is done for.
Jacob, you've really put your foot in it now. What if I smuggle the plates back into the bank?
Well, certainly help. Better yet, it would call into question the stories on Tupini's murder, which would restore confidence in the economy.
That's settled then. Britain lives to see another day.
Oh, and if it's not too much trouble, would you mind destroying any counterfeit notes you come across so they don't circulate?
Of course.
It really is very good of you to help. Follow me. The counterfeit money is being spent nearby. Well, if you can call it counterfeit. With those printing plates, it's nearly impossible to tell the real notes from the fake ones.
Mr. Abelein.
If this gets out... Well, I've said this already. When people don't trust their currency, and we're already seeing riots...
Mr. Abelein.
I have the utmost faith in you, Miss Fry.
You two, follow me. I don't wish to be robbed on my way to the cart.
The counterfeiters.
Heard about the rioting at the bank?
I have they can riot all day long. We won't be giving back those plates.
You think she has someone to
look difference does it make? It's not like he has any real cash on him.
She can't bring
it. Since we've got the printing plates, it's all real cash.
Did you hear those crowds? Sounds like all of London is rioting.
Nothing to do with us.
I can't believe Jacob's managed to shatter the entire economy. Father was right. He acts in haste and repents not at all.
This place is full of us. Just look the other way.
There's been a murder!
Where to now?
She heard it from the coppers.
A scale! Someone's been hurt!
Yes. Terrible shame. But it worked out all right for us, didn't it?
You're not worried. Please be asking off.
Slowly now. There you are.
Keep your eyes open. Anyone could be trying to get in.
Yes, sir.
Keep this place locked down.
Yes, sir.
Guard this place as you would the Bank of England itself.
I'm coming over and teaching you a bloody lesson.
I'll tear you to shreds.
Oh. Whoa. No! Oh. Oh. Knock her dead!
Knock her dead!
Now to sneak these back into the bank. There, as if they were never taken.
The London papers are running the story of how it was all a hoax. No more riots. Faith in the bank restored. Finally, I might get a quiet night on patrol. Miss Fry, I can't thank you enough.
Glad we've averted catastrophe, Sergeant. Although it's Jacob who should be thanking me.